Good morning students, in yesterday's class we have seen about the locus, how to find out the locus of the given point. Okay, so let P be the moving point, let P of x1 comma y1 be the point on the locus nu eduthittu nama kuduthirukka condition ah use panni nama problem continue pannom illaya. Innaiki nama paaka porathu straight lines. It is a very interesting one. You have studied in 10th standard itself about how to find out the equation of straight lines in four forms. நாலு ஃபார்மில் நீ வந்து படிச்சிருக்க, நான் அதை ஜஸ்ட் ரீகால் பண்ண போகிறேன். ஸோ ஃபஸ்ட்டு ஃபார்ம் என்ன அப்படின்னு பார்த்தீங்கன்னா ஸ்லோப் இன்டர்செப்ட் ஃபார்ம், ஈக்குவேஷன் ஆஃப் ஸ்ட்ரெயிட் லைன் இன் ஸ்லோப் இன்டர்செப்ட் ஃபார்ம். அண்ட் தென் செகண்ட் ஒன் இஸ் பாயிண்ட் ஸ்லோப் ஃபார்ம். பாயிண்ட் ஸ்லோப் ஃபார்ம்னு சொல்லுவோம், ஒன் பாயிண்ட் ஸ்லோப் ஃபார்ம்னு சொல்லலாம். ஓகே, பாயிண்ட் ஸ்லோப் ஃபார்ம். அண்ட் த தேர்ட் ஒன் இஸ் two point form, and a fourth one is intercept form. Fourth one is intercept form. So we have studied about all these four forms in the previous classes, isn't it? So I am going to write what is it, and finally it is general form. ஜென்ரல் ஃபார்ம் என்னென்ன உனக்கு தெரியும், இருந்தாலும் நான் இதில் எழுதிட்டு உனக்கு சொல்ல போகிறேன். ஓகேயா? ஸோ இப்போ நம்ம இது என்னென்ன எப்படி எழுதுவோம் அப்படின்னு ஞாபகப்படுத்தலாம். ஈக்குவேஷன் ஆஃப் தி ஸ்ட்ரெயிட் லைன் ஹேவிங் ஸ்லோப் எம் அண்ட் ஒய் இன்டர்செப்ட் சி இஸ், இதை எப்படி எழுதணும், ஒய் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு எம்எக்ஸ் பிளஸ் சி. இது வந்து எம்ங்கிறது வந்து இங்கே ஸ்லோப்பு, சிங்கிறது வந்து ஒய் இன்டர்செப்ட். ஞாபகம் இருக்கா படித்தது? ஐ திங்க் யூ கேன் ஜஸ்ட் ரீகால் திஸ். M is slope and C is y-intercept, and slope-intercept form is y is equal to mx plus c. Okay, and then point slope form. Point slope form na slope vandu m, point vandu x1 comma y1. இங்கே நம்ம எழுதிக்கலாம், இது m and this is c, y-intercept that is c. Okay, so point slope form அவனால சொல்ல முடியுமா, what is the equation for point slope form? Very good. Y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. This is one point slope form. And then what is two point form? Two points na enna rendu point eduthu, x1 comma y1 and x2 comma y2. So these are the two points, isn't it? So what is the equation of the straight line in a two point form? Y minus y1 divided by y2 minus y1 is equal to x minus x1 divided by x2 minus x1. So you can easily write down this. And then what is the intercept form? Intercept form is x by a plus y by b is equal to 1, where a is a x intercept and b is a y intercept. So intercept na a b varum. Adutathu general form. General form for the equation of a straight line is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. So this is the general form. So nama 5 form eludhirukom. First one is slope intercept, y equal to mx plus c. Second one is one point and slope form, that is y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Third one is two point form, y minus y1 divided by y2 minus y1 is equal to x minus x1 divided by x2 minus x1. And fourth one is intercept form, x by a plus y by b is equal to 1. And fifth one is general form, ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Okay, so these are all the things we have studied in the 10th standard. Now what is the new one we are going to see here? அப்படின்னு பார்த்தீங்கன்னா ஆங்கிள் பிட்வீன் டூ ஸ்ட்ரெயிட் லைன்ஸ் நம்ம கண்டுபிடிக்க போகிறோம். ஸோ ஹவு டு ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் த ஆங்கிள் பிட்வீன் டூ ஸ்ட்ரெயிட் லைன்ஸ். நெக்ஸ்ட் டாபிக் இஸ் ஆங்கிள் பிட்வீன் டூ ஸ்ட்ரெயிட் லைன்ஸ். Okay, angle between two straight lines I am going to find out. So I am going to write down the formula for finding the angle between two straight lines. Let L1 and L2 be the two straight lines by the equation y equal to m1 x plus c1 and y equal to m2 x plus c2 intersecting at the point P. Theta 1 and theta 2 be the two angles. Then the slope of the lines are m1 and m2. Okay. First let us write down. Let m1, m2 be the slope of two lines. Rendu lines nama eduthukrom illaya and rendu lines ku slope vandu m1 m2. Let theta be the angle between them. Let theta be the angle between two lines. Okay, so what's the formula? Theta is equal to tan inverse of modulus of m1 minus m2 divided by, sorry, theta is equal to tan inverse of modulus of m1 minus m2 divided by 1 plus m1 into m2. So after finding the slope of the two lines, we have to use this formula to find the angle between two lines. So how can you find out the slope of a line? Slope of a line can be find out using the formula minus coefficient of x divided by coefficient of y. அப்படின்னு நம்ம கண்டுபிடிக்கலாம். சரியா? இதே இது when the two straight lines are parallel, when the, if the slopes are equal, two lines are perpendicular, if the slopes are product of the slope is minus 1. அதை நோட்டா எழுதிக்கலாம். If two lines are parallel, two lines are parallel அப்படின்னு ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணிக்கலாம். Two lines are parallel when the slopes are equal. M1 is equal to M2. அப்படின்னா, we can say that the two given lines are parallel. இதேது, two lines are perpendicular. Two lines are perpendicular when the product of the slope is minus 1. Product of the slope is minus 1. So this can be written like this. That is, slopes are equal na, m1 is equal to m2. We can say that the lines are parallel. The lines are perpendicular when m1 into m2 is equal to minus 1. Okay. So we have to be very clear with these two things. Okay. Next one, we can go with the next formula. Distance between a point from a line. Distance between a point from a line. Distance between a point from a line. So for example, இப்படி இருக்குன்னு வச்சுக்கோங்க, இந்த பாயிண்ட்ல இருந்து இந்த லைனுக்குள்ள இந்த டிஸ்டன்ஸ் கண்டுபிடிக்கணும். இப்போ இந்த லைன் வந்து பி, இந்த பாயிண்ட்டை வந்து நம்ம பின்னு எடுத்துக்கிட்டோம். பி ஆஃப் எக்ஸ் ஒன் கமா ஒய் ஒன் லைன் வந்து நமக்கு எப்பவுமே என்னது, ஏஎக்ஸ் பிளஸ் பிஒய் பிளஸ் சி ஈக்குவல் டு ஜீரோ அப்படின்னு சொல்றோம்னு வச்சுக்கோ. ஸோ வாட்ஸ் த டிஸ்டன்ஸ் பிட்வீன் த பாயிண்ட், லென்த் ஆஃப் த பெர்பெண்டிகுலர் ஃப்ரம் த பாயிண்ட் டு த லைன். So, ரெண்டு ஃபார்முலா எழுத போகிறோம். லென்த் ஆஃப் பர்பண்டிகுலர் ஃப்ரம் பி ஆஃப் எக்ஸ் ஒன் கமா ஒய் ஒன் டு த லைன் ஏஎக்ஸ் பிளஸ் பிஒய் பிளஸ் சி ஈக்குவல் டு ஜீரோ எஸ். வாட்ஸ் த ஃபார்முலா? D is equal to distance எப்போவுமே மாடுலஸ், ஏன்னா நமக்கு வந்து டிஸ்டன்ஸ் வந்து ஆல்வேஸ் பாசிட்டிவாக இருக்கணும். ஏஎக்ஸ் ஒன் பிளஸ் பிஒய் ஒன் பிளஸ் சி டிவைடட் பை ரூட் ஆஃப் a square plus b square. Okay. So x1, y1 and the point akondu undu in the line la inda edathila nama substitute pannittu divided by x coefficient and y coefficient edutha square panni sum panni you have to take the square root. Okay. So this is the formula. Idhe formula vandu innonu irukku second one. Length of perpendicular from the origin. Length of perpendicular from origin to the line. Origin 0, 0 to the line AX plus BY plus C equal to 0 is. இதுக்கு formula பாரு. D is equal to. நமக்கு 0, 0 போட்டுப்பா. இந்த ரெண்டு term என்ன வாயிரும். AX1, BY1, 2, 0 வாயிரும். அப்பா, C divided by root of A square plus B square. Because the point is 0, 0, when you are substituting 0 here and 0 here, you will get a 0 in the coefficient of A and B. So, you are getting C divided by root of A square plus B square. So, this is the two formula we need to see for distance between a point from a line. Okay. And then finally, we are having the concurrence of three lines. Conditions for three given straight lines to be concurrent. To be concurrent. நீங்க இது லாஸ்ட் இயர் படிச்சிருப்பீங்க. கன்கரண்ட்னா என்ன பண்ணுவனா ரெண்டு லைனை கொடுத்துருக்க ரெண்டு லைன் ஈக்குவேஷனை எடுத்து இன்டர்செக்டிங் பாயிண்ட் கண்டுபிடிச்சு தேர்ட் லைன்ல சப்ஸ்டிட் பண்ணி பார்ப்பேன். அப்போ வென் யூ ஆர் கெட்டிங் த ஆன்சர் அஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஜீரோ யூ வில் சே தட் த த்ரீ லைன்ஸ் ஆர் கன்கரண்ட். ஆனால் இங்கே வந்து நம்ம டிட்டர்மினன்ட் யூஸ் பண்ண போகிறோம். ஏன்னா வி ஹவ் ஸ்டடிட் அபவுட் டிட்டர்மினன்ட் இசன்ட் இட். ஸோ இட் இஸ் வெரி ஈஸியர் ஃபார் அஸ் டு யூஸ் டிட்டர்மினன்ட். So let the three lines be a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0, and finally a3x plus b3y plus c3 equal to 0 னு இருந்துச்சுனா the condition for concurrent is the determinant value should be equal to 0. அதாவது determinant of A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3, C3. மூணு லைன்ஸ்லையும் நீ கோஎஃபிஷியன்ஸையும் கான்ஸ்டன்ட்டை ஈக்குவல் கோஎஃபிஷியன்ஸ் ஆஃப் எக்ஸ் ஒய் கான்ஸ்டன்ட்டை டிட்டர்மினண்டில் போட்டு டிட்டர்மினன்ட் வேல்யூ கண்டுபிடிக்கிறப்ப வென் இட் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஜீரோ வி கேன் சே தட் த கிவன் த்ரீ லைன்ஸ் ஆர் concurrent. So it is very easier finding the determinant. We can say that the given lines are concurrent or not. Okay. So in today's class, we are going to see about how to find out the equation of the straight line and then find the angle between the given lines and then how to find out the given lines are concurrent. Okay. So the first one, let us go with the first problem example. So, example sum, let us move with. Example 3.4. Find the acute angle. Find the acute angle between the lines 2x minus y plus 3 equal to 0 and x plus y plus 2 equal to 0. So, let M1 and M2 be the slope of the given two lines. M1 and M2 be the slopes. So, what is the formula for slope of the given straight line? Slope is equal to minus coefficient of x divided by coefficient of y. இது வந்து நீ லாஸ்ட் இயரே படிச்சிருக்க. ஸோ ஜஸ்ட் ரீகால் திஸ். ஸோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் லைன்லேருந்து M1 கண்டுபிடிப்போம். 2x பிளஸ் ஒய் சாரி 2x மைனஸ் ஒய் பிளஸ் 3 ஈக்குவல் டு 0. So m1 is equal to minus coefficient of x divided by coefficient of y. So m1 is equal to 2. Similarly, for the second line, x plus y plus 2 equal to 0. So m2 is equal to minus coefficient of x divided by coefficient of y. Therefore, m2 is equal to minus 1. Okay, so we have found out what is m1, what is m2. Let theta be the angle between them. Angle between them. You write it in the full form, okay? So theta is equal to, what's the formula? Tan inverse of m1 minus m2 divided by 1 plus m1 into m2. So this is equal to tan inverse of m1 is 2 minus of minus 1, it will become as plus 1 divided by 1 minus minus 1 into 2 minus 2. So your answer is tan inverse of 3 divided by minus 1. So it is nothing but tan inverse of minus 3. Modulus of minus 3 is plus 3. Therefore, theta is equal to tan inverse of 3. Okay. So this is the angle between the two straight lines. Okay. Next question. Let us go with some exercise problems. So let us go with exercise 3.2. Find the exercise 3.2. Find the angle. Slopes are given. Slope m1 is given as 1 by 2 and m2 is given as 3. Okay, find the angle. So what is theta? Theta is equal to tan inverse of modulus of m1 minus m2 divided by 1 plus m1 m2. So slope is straight a kuduttaanga. Slope kudukalaina previous example summary we have to find out the slope. Here the slopes are straight away given. So we can easily try with this problem. 1 by 2 minus 3 divided by 1 plus 3 by 2. 1 by 2 into 3 is 3 by 2. Okay. So tan inverse of minus 6 plus 1, that is minus 5 by 2 divided by 2 plus 3, 5 by 2. So it is tan inverse of modulus of minus 1. Modulus of minus 1 is plus 1. Tan inverse of plus 1. So tan inverse of plus 1, tan la yenga 1 varum, tan la yenga 1 varum, we will get in the form place of 45 degree. So theta is equal to 45 degree. Illena idha nee ipdi niyabam vechikalam, inda tan inverse inda pakkam poichuna tan theta is equal to 1 nu eluduva. 1 is nothing but tan 45. So the answer for theta is equal to 45 degree. So tan inverse ngiradha indha pakkam eduthu vandona tan theta. Okay, so you can easily remember this. Next problem. Find the distance of the point from the line. Find the distance of the point. Find the distance of 4, 1 from the line 3x minus 4y plus 12 equal to 0. Okay. So what's the formula for the distance? Modulus of ax1 plus by1 plus c divided by root of a square plus b square. First write down what is here. x1, y1 is equal to 4, 1. What is a? A 3, b is minus 4 and c is 12. Okay, let us substitute all this. So d is equal to modulus of 3x1 means 4 plus minus 4 into y1, that is 1, plus c is 12 divided by root of 3 square plus minus 4 the whole square. So you are getting 12 minus 4 plus 12 divided by root of 9 plus 16 modulus. Okay, so 12 plus 12 is 24, 24 minus 4 is 20. 20 divided by root of 25, that is 5. So modulus of 20 by 5, that is nothing but 4 units. So the distance is equal to 4 units. So first write down what is A, B, C and what is X1, Y1, then you can easily find out the answer. Okay. Next question, your homework show that the straight lines are concurrent. Determinant kandupidi, determinant kandupidicha 0 nu solitina the given lines are concurrent nu solliralam. Okay, yeah. So next one, we are moving with problem number 4. Problem number 4, the given 3 lines, find A when the lines are concurrent. 3 lines enna nu paathina 3x plus 4y equal to 13. Nama minus 13 eludhikano. Next line vandu 2x minus 7y equal to minus 1. Third line is ax minus y minus 14 equal to 0 are concurrent. Kuduthirukanga. Inda 3 lines vandu concurrent ah irundhuchuna what is the value for a nu ketirukanga. So when the 3 lines are concurrent, the determinant, since the 3 lines are concurrent, the determinant value will be equal to 0. Illaya determinant value eppadi eluduva 3 4 taking 13 to this side it will become as minus 13 and then 2 minus 7 1 and a minus 1 minus 14 equal to 0. So in the equation rendu in the pakkam eludhikkanum 3x plus 4y minus 13 equal to 0 nu eludhikkom. Adutathu 2x minus 7y plus 1 equal to 0 nu eludhikkanum. Inga namakku already constant in the side da irukku. So idhukku determinant kandupidikka porom. So I think you know how to find out the determinant. First let us start the determinant by using the first row. 3 into minus 7 into minus 14 plus 98 minus 1 plus 1 it will become minus 4 center la minus 28 minus a minus 13 into minus 2 plus 7a equal to 0. Now expand this 99 into 3, that is 297. Here it is 28 into 4, that is 112 plus 4a plus 26 minus 91a is equal to 0. Okay, so we are, when you are adding all these 3, you will get a 435 minus 87a is equal to 0. So minus 87a is equal to minus 435. So a is equal to minus 435 divided by minus 87, a equal to 5. So the value for a is 5. Okay, so you can easily find out the value for a. Now the next problem number 5, fifth problem. A manufacturer produces 80 TV at a cost of rupees kuduthirukku, 125 TV at a cost of rupees kuduthirukku, assuming the cost curve to be linear. Linear and the word and yaba ochko apoor equation of a straight line kandupidikka porom. Find the linear expression of the given information. Also estimate the cost of 95 TV sets. Okay, first let us write down, let x represent TV sets, number of TV sets. Okay, y represent cost. Okay, so let us make a column for this. Okay, so let us write down TV, number of TV vandu X, cost vandu Y, kuduthirukka datas na eludhuren. First vandu 80 TV sets, adutathu 125 TV sets and then this is 2,20,000 and here it is 2,87,500. Find the linear expression. Linear expression is nothing but the straight line equation. Equation of straight line. It is nothing but equation of straight line. Linear nala enadhu straight line. Okay. So ipa idhula paathina, let us consider this as x1, y1, x2, and this will be y1 and this will be y2. So idha first nama eduthukonom. Ipa what is the equation of a straight line? Equation of straight line when two points are known as y minus y1 divided by y2 minus y1 is equal to x minus x1 divided by x2 minus x1. So, idhila nama substitute panna porom. So, let us go with this. That is y minus y1 is 2,20,000 divided by y2 is 2,87,500. Minus 2,20,000 is equal to x minus 80 divided by 125 minus 80. Okay. So y minus 2,20,000 divided by idu rendai nee subtract pannina you will get 67,500. Inga vandu x minus 80 divided by idu rendai subtract pannina 45. So we can cancel this 45 one times and this is for 1500 times, 15 times or so. So you can cancel and cross multiply. 1 into y minus 2,20,000 is equal to 45 into x minus 80. Okay, so 1 into will be same value. So y minus 2,20,000 is equal to 45x minus, not 45, it is 1500, sorry. Thousand five hundred x minus 80 into 1500, that is 1,20,000. Okay, so taking x to one side, y is equal to namak linear equation venum laya appa minus 1,20,000 plus 2,20,000 inda pakkam na kondu vandiren, so it will become as 2,20,000 from 1,20,000 from 2,20,000, you will get 1,00,000. So minus 1,00,000. So this is the required linear expression. Therefore, linear expression is y is equal to 1500x minus 1,00,000. Okay. And then we need to find out when x is equal to 95. What will be the cost? 95 TV sets vandhi evlo cost in ketrakanga. So, idhila nama substitute panikla. Y equal to 1500 into 95 minus 1,00,000. Abdina potona. We can easily find out the answer. 1,42,500 minus 1,00,000. So the cost of the TV set, 95 TV set is 2,42,000. Sorry, it is plus. The paru idu plus. Ena 95 sets kuda varum. Eppadi thappa kandupidikka theriyano pillaingala? That will be easier for you to find out. So we can say therefore cost of 95 TV sets is rupees 2,42,500. Okay. So this is a 5-mark question. You can study it. Okay. And one more example I am going to do now. Similar to this, you are having many examples. You can try it as homework. So, one example we shall continue. example 3.6. Angle between two lines is given as pi by 4. Given la pathingna, angle kuduthirukanga. Theta is equal to pi by 4. One slope is given. So m1 is given as 3. Find m2, other slope. Appadina ketirukanga. So na kuduthirukada data va eluditen. One angle between two lines is given as pi by 4. Slope of one of the line is 3, that is m1, and we need to find the slope of the other line. So it is tan theta is equal to, what's the formula we know comparing all this? Tan theta is equal to modulus of m1 minus m2 divided by 1 plus m1 m2. So tan theta will have tan pi by 4. Tan pi by 4 is nothing but 45 degree, isn't it? M1 is 3 minus m2 divided by 1 plus 3 m2. Okay, so tan pi by 4 is nothing but tan 45, that is 1. 1 is equal to 3 minus m2 divided by 1 plus 3 m2. So cross multiplying this, 1 plus 3 m2 is equal to 3 minus m2. So taking m2 to this side, you are getting 4m2 is equal to 3 minus 1. So 4m2 is equal to 2. So m2 is equal to 2 by 4. That is the other slope is 1 by 2. Therefore, the slope of other line is 1 by 2. Okay. So it will be easier when you are doing this problem. Okay. Next one. One more question in example. You show that the given lines are concurrent and find the concurrent point. Abdini ketirukanga. Example 3.7. Show that the three lines are concurrent. 3x minus 4y minus 13 equal to 0. 8x minus 11y equal to 33, 2x minus 3y minus 7 equal to 0. Show that three lines are concurrent. Three lines are concurrent. And find the concurrent point. And find the concurrent point. So, ரெண்டு லைனை நம்ம சால்வ் பண்ணி கன்கரண்ட் பாயிண்ட் கண்டுபிடிச்சிடலாம் இஃப் வி ஷோ தட் த த்ரீ லைன்ஸ் ஆர் கன்கரண்ட் அப்படின்னு காமிச்சிட்டோம்னா. ஓகேயா? ஸோ த்ரீ லைன்ஸ் ஆர் கன்கரண்ட்னா என்ன ப்ரூவ் பண்ணணும்? கண்டிஷன் ஃபார் கன்கரண்ட் லைன் இஸ் ஏ ஒன் பி ஒன் சி ஒன், ஏ டூ பி டூ சி டூ, ஏ த்ரீ பி த்ரீ சி த்ரீ ஈக்குவல் டு ஜீரோ, இல்லையா? ஸோ லெட் அஸ் டேக் கண்டிஷன் ஃபார் கன்கரண்ட் லைன்ஸ். கண்டிஷன் இஸ் 3 minus 4 minus 13, 8 minus 11 minus 33, 2 minus 3 minus 7 should be equal to 0. அப்போ LHS எடுத்துட்டு RHS 0 வருதான்னு செக் பண்ணுவோம். இப்போ LHS வந்து 3 minus 4 minus 13, 8 minus 11 minus 33, 2 minus 3 minus 7. ஸோ இதுக்கு டிட்டர்மினன்ட் கண்டுபிடிக்கலாம். ஸோ லெட் அஸ் ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் த டிட்டர்மினன்ட். 3 into 77 minus 99 plus 4 into plus ஆயிரும், ஏன்னா அங்கே மைனஸ் இருக்கு, minus 56 plus 66 minus 13 into minus 24 plus 22 minus 24. Okay, so 3 into minus 22 plus 4 into 10 minus 13 into minus 2. So you are getting minus 66 plus 40 plus 26 equal to 0, that is equal to RHS. Therefore, the three lines are concurrent. Three lines are concurrent. We need to find out the concurrent point. So how can you find out the concurrent point? To find a point of concurrence, to find the point of concurrence, let us solve any two equations. Okay, so let us solve equation 1. Equation 1 implies 3x minus 4y minus 13 equal to 0. And let us take equation 3 because it is a simple equation. 2x minus 3y minus 7 equal to 0. So first equation into 2 implies 6x minus 8y minus 26 is equal to 0. Third equation into 3 implies 6x minus 9y minus 21 equal to 0. Now solve this. Minus plus plus. So cancel this. Y minus 5 is equal to 0. So y is equal to 5. Okay, so we are getting y equal to 5. So put y equal to 5. Put y equal to 5 in equation 2. In equation 2 la vandu potom appadina 8x minus 11 into 5 is equal to 33. Appa 8x is equal to 33. Minus 55 comes to this side as plus 55. 8x is equal to 88. Appa x is equal to 11. Okay. Therefore, the point of concurrence is point of concurrence C is 11, 5. So, taking any two equations and substituting in the third equation, we can easily say that the point of concurrence. Okay. So, with this, today class is over. Tomorrow class, we can go to the next exercise. So, today's homework is exercise 3.2, problem number 3. Problem number 3 you have to do. And in example, we have to continue with example 3.4. I have finished. So, take it as homework 3.5 and 3.8. Okay. This is your homework. So, in today's class, we have seen with how to find out the angle between two straight lines and how to find, say whether the given lines are concurrent, isn't it? And we have seen with the two-point formula, we have solved a linear expression. Okay, similar to that linear expression problem, you are having example 3.8 as homework. So try to complete all the problems in your classwork and do the homework using black pen. Next class we shall see with the next exercise. Okay, thank you students.